In this module, you will learn the safe usage of a scalpel. A scalpel comprises of a Bart Parker handle and a disposable blade. Here, I have two of the most commonly used sizes of BP handle. On my left is a number 3 handle, which you can see has the number 3 clearly embossed there. And on the right side, there is a number 4 handle, once again, with a clear marking. Notice that at the working end of the handle, there's always an oblique groove that is designed to align with the base of the blade that we attach to the handle. The number 3 handle accommodates blades in the 10 series, which includes blade numbers 10, 11, 12, 13, and so forth. The number 4 BP handle accommodates blades in the 20 series, including 20, 21, 22, 23, and so forth. My OR team member is about to introduce a number 22 blade into the sterile field. Never grab the blade directly with your hands. Instead, use a needle driver to grasp it. If necessary, adjust the blade's orientation in the needle driver using plain forceps. Place the needle driver at the non-cutting edge of the blade towards its tip. Ensure that you do not accidentally cross-clamp the blade across its entire width, because this can cause damage to the leading or cutting edge. Also, avoid obstructing the aperture that engages with the BP handle. Align the blade and the handle so that the oblique base of the blade aligns with the oblique groove on the BP handle. Gently slide the blade onto the handle until you hear an audible click. Now, the scalpel is ready for use. When passing the scalpel to team members, never do so holding it in your hand, and never place it loose within the surgical field. Always lay it down or pass it within a kidney tray to prevent injury to yourself and your team members. Unloading a blade can be challenging and often poses a risk of injury either to yourself or another member of the operating team. Hold the scalpel in your left hand and take a needle driver in your right. Instead of holding the blade near the tip as we did before, hold it proximally near the base. Engage the ratchet and lift the blade's base upwards to disengage it. Then move it distally by a few millimeters by applying pressure with your left thumb on the needle driver in your right hand. This helps control the motion of the blade. Now, reposition the needle driver towards the tip and pull back on the handle. You are therefore detaching the handle from the blade rather than the blade from the handle. This minimizes any unnecessary movement of the blade, reducing the risk of injury. You may now dispose of the blade in your sharps bin